All right, so we got our last bird here from today's hunt. We got 11 teal, 7 blue wings, and 4 green wings. And we're gonna do a little catch, clean, cook with these guys. We decided we're gonna do some jalapeno poppers. And got the ladies inside doing the cream cheese and all that and stuff, prepping the peppers. And I'm just gonna come in here, turn them on open, put my thumb in there. A little bit of a feather mess. I'm just gonna clean them all off before I start cutting, or else you get them all in the breast. Yeah, it's no fun because you gotta spend more time getting the feathers out of the water and stuff later on. So, start them sternum. Jesus, just cut that sternum. These knives are really sharp, guys. If you're new to them, don't. They're definitely not a toy. It's, you poke your finger and you're getting hurt. So, you got both layers, your tenderloin breast in there, and other breasts. I go underneath everything.
So basically what he's going to be doing here is he's going to follow that breastbone on each side, and from there he's going to follow all along will be like their version of a rib cage, and then all the way up to their collarbone, and then cut the collarbone off. If you guys are interested in these knives, this is a Havilon replaceable blade knife. That's what I use. I would actually rather have a solid non-folding one because it makes it easier to clean, but what I got works. I like the bright handle on this one because it's easy to find in the field. Obviously we're not using it in the field right now. And then you're just going to follow those ribs down.
Yep. Once you pass the tenderloin, I'll show you on the next one. Once you hit past the tenderloin, that's when you drop down, straight down the side to save the most meat. You know, I lost a little bit right there, but I mean, the main game is just trying to save as much meat as possible. Got a little wishbone up there, kind of thing. I don't know what it's called. Don't know if ducks have a wishbone. This guy, you kind of just peel it up. Then you got the elbow. So I guess it's the shoulder joint, pretty much. But you got meat on your side of it. Cut it to it. That's how you save as much. Oh, I lost some meat there. Could have done a little better, but. Is that breast?
Nope, sure.
All clean, start trimming that fat off. Some people like the fat, some people don't. But we'll leave it on there.
So basically, you're just gonna repeat the same thing on the other side. You know, we just breast them out. We actually did something with skin on the other day. It's just a preference thing. Some people say, oh, you gotta do it with skin on. Some people don't care. We're one of those people, we got a bunch of them to do. We're gonna take not do the skin on. We did that yesterday, and didn't make a huge difference, so it's for cleaning quick purposes. We got other stuff to do today. We shouldn't do it this way. So when the next thing you'll see is us putting jalapeno poppers together.
All right, we're ready to make the jalapeno poppers. We got most of them ready to go. We started off with keeping seeds in, put them back in after you get the veins and stuff out of the pepper. Slightly cook them, keep it get some hotter. We take our cream cheese over here, which we got cream cheese, Parmesan, and a secret seasoning that I don't really know what's in it. It's my brother's. Little special stuff. Just spreading the cream cheese. I do it about level, maybe a little more depending on how much you like cream cheese. And then I do a teal breast in half. I like my meat. I think a lot of people do. You set that down for a second. Take your bacon, come over here. We got our brown sugar and maple sauce. Just kind of throw it on there and make a little layer on there. And it'll caramelize onto the bacon. The fat of the bacon will absorb the sweetness and this tastes awesome. And I do the maple side on the inside so it kind of gets trapped in there. And wrap it up. There we go. And you put a little bit of drizzle on top to make it extra sweet. Oops. Grab some. Gonna seal her up.
Do you want to see?
There we go. Ready for the the oven. Well, that's our finished product. Nice cooked pepper, cream cheese, our duck, and our bacon. We left the seeds in, so it's got a nice little spice to it. Recommend trying it, guys.